I found some simple sine wave oscillators on the internet, all made with the 741, and I decided to test one because I couldn't find out whether the circuit needed double voltage, positive and negative, etc., etc. So I made this experimental setup on my breadboard, used my double power supply and tested this circuit. And these are my conclusions. This resistor has to be quite low, the back coupling resistor here. This resistor also. And here I use two 10k potentiometers. That works. I use here a 5k potentiometer connected to the zero to set the amplitude. And I found out that the circuit needed a double power supply, negative and positive. And these pins are going to zero, and that's often ground. This video is about the problems from this circuit, especially that it is very critical to get the proper sine wave. Here you see the sine wave that's generated now. I turn one of the potentiometers to set the op-amp, and you can also can see already that when I touch it and push and pull a little bit, the whole thing stops oscillating. So this is a very critical setting, and that's this potentiometer here. It's critical, and it has also to do with these two other potentiometers. That's what I demonstrate now. Here you can also see that there is a very sharp point where the whole circuit acts as a sine wave oscillator. But when I push the potentiometer somewhat over that point, it stops. So, an interesting circuit to do experiments with, especially to find how you can stabilize the amplitude. One of the big problems with a sine wave oscillator, the amplitude has to be constant on the broad frequency range. And this can be done with an incandescent lamp. That's all well known, and you'll find much more information about this on the internet. The only thing that I wanted to give here in this video is a working circuit with which you can do experiments and develop it further. So I wish you luck with experiments.